Giving a test to a group of students, the grades and gender are summarized below. If one student is chosen at random, find the probability that the student did not get a B. Let's first find this probability using the basic probability formula, and then we'll use the formula for the complement of an event. So using the basic probability formula, the probability of a student not having a grade of B would be equal to the favorable number of outcomes divided by the total number of outcomes, or in this case, it would be the total number of students not getting a B divided by the total number of students taking the test. Well, looking at the table, if a student did not get a B, they either received an A or a C. Notice 28 students received an A, which is not a B, and 23 students received a C, which is not a B. And then finally, a total of 89 students took the test. So the probability that a student did not get a B would be equal to 28 plus 23, the favorable number of outcomes, or the number of grades that were not a B, divided by the total number of students taking the test, which is 89. Which gives us 51 divided by 89 for the probability a random student did not get a B. Probability can be expressed as a fraction, decimal, or percentage. Let's leave this as a fraction for right now, but notice how if this did simplify, we should, but this does not simplify. Now let's use the complement formula given here. The probability of not B, which we could also write as B with a bar over it, is also equal to 1 minus the probability of a B, which would be 1 minus the probability of a student receiving a B would be equal to the number of students that received a B divided by the total number of students that took the test. We'll notice that 38 students received a B. Therefore, the probability that a student received a B would be 38 divided by 89. And now let's find this difference. 1 is equal to 89/89. Again, notice how this is equal to 1, but now we have a common denominator. So we can go ahead and subtract. Notice how this does give us 51/89. So of course the probability is the same whether we use the basic probability formula or the probability for the complement of an event. Let's also take the time to write this probability as a decimal and a percentage. To convert a fraction to a decimal, we would divide. So we'd have 51 divided by 89. Let's round to 4 decimal places. So this would be approximately 0.5730. Notice how the 3 here indicates to round down. As a percentage, we would multiply by 100 and add a percent sign, or move the decimal point to the right 2 times, giving us 57.30%. Just keep in mind the fractional value is exact, and the decimal and percentage are approximations. I hope you found this helpful.